During this session, we are going to cover Adobe Analytics, segments, and classifications. First up item will be what is a segment? Next, how to build one. After that, what is a classification? And lastly, how to build one of those. For citation, I included a textbook definition of what a segment is. So you may be asking, what exactly is a segment? The image to the right contains a visual example of segmentation. I like to think of segments as a way to parse your audience into specified groups for analysis. In Adobe, we can create segments to be as general or as specific as necessary to meet your campaign criteria. For example, the orange group here could represent pizza. The navy blue group could represent tacos, and the yellow group could represent mushrooms. These are all different ways to parse your groups to make your data easier to digest and for analysis. Segments can be based on the following values. First one would be visitor based on attributes. So for this example, we have a city. Visitor based on interactions. And for this example, we are using the mall crosswalk as the interaction. Visitor based on mall exits, which is the down red arrow showing people leaving, folks leaving the mall, or entries. The green arrows are focusing on folks who are going into the mall or the mall area. And then also, we can have visitors based on a custom variable. For this example, I use a custom variable of umbrellas. As we see, there are two folks down here that are using the umbrella and would be in that segmentation. So with that in mind, let's create an Adobe segment. First, what you'll do is log into your Adobe platform and create a project, workspace, and choose an existing report or create a new one. Next, what you'll do when you're inside is click on components, and you should see the option of create segment. If the segments are disabled, contact your administrator for assistance and they will be able to help you move forward with that. Now, let's create a use case. In this example, we would like to create a segment by combining operating system types, iOS or Android. So the first thing that I do when creating a segment is to name it. And as you can see, I have already named it operating system types, iOS or Android. Next, best practices would be to add a description or tags. A description is added so that someone who is taking a general look at your report has an idea of what the report is going to, what type of information that report is going to give you. Tags make your reports and segments easier to search. So like I said, these two fields of description and tags are optional, but they're definitely good habits to form. Next, we move on to the definition. Here, we can include data at the visitor, visit, or the hit level. For this example, I selected the visitor level. After this, what you'll want to do is go back to your segment builder, and you will pull in either a segment or a dimension. So for this example, this orange bar represents a dimension. I pulled an operating system, and this equal sign here, there are a number of different options that are in there. So it's equal, does not equal, so on and so forth type of logic that you'll definitely want to use. After that, we can use this down arrow and you can choose either the Apple iOS and also the Google Android. For this example, go back over here to the left. I have the logic, I'm using the logic of or. You can use and, or then. Just make sure that you are very specific and you use the correct value so that your metrics aggregate correctly. After that, we do the best part, which is to press save. Once you save your segment, this is the best part. Once you save your segment, you are able to actually bring that segment to life and bring your metrics to life. So what you'll do is you can go to your components, pull in that new segment that you've created and any metrics that you want to associate with it. So for this example, I pulled in the operating system types, iOS or Android. And as you can see, I pulled that in at the visitor level. Over here, what I'm showing the iOS and Android split of the aggregated numbers of visitors that are with iOS or Android. One good way to check this information is basically pull in the segment you created and then also pull in the parts of the segment that you had created. These two numbers should pretty much match, like when you add them together, they should match the operating type system, iOS or Android segment that was just created. All right, and that right there concludes the segment portion of this presentation. Now we are going to move on to classifications. So a classification is a way of categorizing analytics variable data, then displaying that data in different ways when you generate reports. When classifying, you are establishing a relationship between the variable and the metadata related to that variable. Classifications are most frequently used in campaigns. Data collected using variables such as evars, props, and events. Information can be rolled up by applying metadata to the values collected in the variables. So how does Claravine help with this? You can use the solutions platform in a number of different scenarios. First, you'll want to work with the CSM, that's someone that's like myself or anyone else on the team, to create a template that standardizes your variables and metadata. So as you can see here, I created a template with the campaign, source, and medium. Here's all of our metadata below. Next, work with your team to create an Adobe target. An Adobe target uses your connected accounts to create specific interactions with integrations. In other words, the standards platform pushes data from the template to the appropriate report suite and classification set up within Adobe. So you will work with your team to do this, because this information you may not necessarily have readily available. And you also work with our teams, the CSM teams, to get this set up correctly. We can also push data to other sources. So for example, we can push data to email or S3 buckets or many other variables that we have that we can push data to. Finally, the last step, what you're going to want to do is log into your Adobe platform and pull in metrics and dimensions and segments, and you will see the data that we have pushed from Claravine to populate in Adobe. And just want to say that concludes my presentation on creating segments and classifications within Adobe. Thank you all for attending, and let me know if you have any questions.